consider a genius level solution to a multitude of modern day problems. This mystery meat treat you see before you is known as SPAM, mystery meaty treat. Delicious in both purpose and nutritional application. Its versatility is practically unmatched. Anything from sliced and fried to chilled and spread. The possibilities are limitless, and yet its contents are, for the most part, unknown, save for one. And it's this one secret ingredient that makes it the belle of the ball in most quietly cannibalistic cultures. Our master chefs, armed with oversized meat grinders, position themselves outside of each Pussifer's presentation in the hopes that one or more of you still can't figure out how to be. All cell phone policy violators, once removed from the venue, are then placed in these oversized processors, ground to a frozen, and then added into the rest of the spamming. Ground up. The inevitable, ignorant, entitled outrage adds just the right amount of spice to the mix. Yum. Thank you in advance for your dim-witted culinary contribution.
Thank you. Agent Gunnar Olsen. Agent Greg Evans. Very excited to be here. We're on a super secret, top secret mission, which is classes up. Let the probing continue.
Sing the battle. facility deep within a fashion backward clickbait wormhole. This alien-owned and operated laboratory appears to be run by a combination of genetic engineers, public relations biologists, booking agents, and smart social media influencers. All extraterrestrial in nature. The purpose of the clones is still a mystery, but it appears that the aliens are duplicating and or replacing red carpet celebrities that have been cursed with mediocre or outdated fashion sensibilities. It's okay, Brittany, you're safe. When attacking the clones, some celebrities, the results can be extremely unstable. What is unclear is whether or not the tragedy originated in the host or manifested in the clone. However, what is clear is that in their attempt to clone some of the more volatile hosts, they are more than just one tragedy walking the red carpets of the socialite world. More than one tragedy. Some anomalies seem to be occurring during the cloning process, where the cloned embryos split to form identical clones that differ greatly from their host. For example, Tom Hardy and Logan Marshall Powell originate from Hogan, and although different from their host, they're identical. The host here is unknown, but the resulting clones of Margot Robbie, Jamie Presley, Samara Weaving, and Emma McKay, Gillian Jacobs, Lauren Gurman, There are other examples of clone embryos splitting, but with disastrous results. Here we have an absolute train wreck, most likely tracing back to the hosts. These seemingly identical clones are far from it. Of these twins, one has uncontrolled potty mouth, tragically so. And the other, although impeccable taste in music, is completely surrounded by enabling assholes. One of the patterns we've observed is during the pod insemination, the clone emerges at the exact age of the host at the time of the insemination, but the host appears to continue to age. In the case of host Fran Drescher, you have a new clone known as Mila Kunis, who is a much younger version of host Drescher. And then in turn, clone Emstone is the much younger version of host Kunis. So as you can see, all with different ages and levels of talent. We'll be right back.
changes come.
Thank you.
Sophia Minor sub-7. Allegedly, an ancient pharaoh's DNA was harvested in an attempt to bring back some of the glorious pageantry of that age. And the resulting clones were so close to this perfection, but unfortunately perished with permanent decision-making disorders and bad hair day. All day. Every day. It appears that when the aliens introduced some of the clones to the red carpet prematurely, bad things could happen. Even with the controlled introduction of harmless ingredients such as alcohol, pharmaceuticals, a modicum of composure can be somewhat maintained in these freshman clones. But when the cofactors of attention and fame are added, things can really go sideways. This one's caliente. This one down here is caliente. This one over here with its back to the camera is a caliente. But this one is a caliente. Caliente, 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 caliente. Occasionally, an ET becomes infatuated with our glamorous pop culture and decides to infiltrate themselves rather than inserting a clone, which is understandable. What's Travis gonna wear to the Oscars this year? Who's gonna underestimate Lady Gaga at the Grammys? Who's Pete gonna poop on this week? What's Madonna gonna announce to remain relevant? And so, it's all so exciting. Example, we began to suspect that Plasmatic's very own Wendy Williams was in fact an alien. So, to keep one step ahead of us, she faked her own death and then underwent gender reassignment only to reemerge as vocalist Maynard James which, although a little obvious, was fairly seamless, but with one complication. Although he gained a dick, he also became one, which is, of course,
guys. Wait, bartender. 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 Bartender.
The bartender?
Where the fuck's the...
I'm over here!
Were you supposed to be there? One of them men in black and black looking motherfuckers? It's a secret, right? Oh shit. Let me ask you something. Serious question. What's up with the Jewish space lasers, man? Do you use those to activate the Kenny G chip you put in the vaccine? And then you use it to track my browser history? Well, then I'm fucked. I'm just kidding, man. I don't use it anymore. I do use booze, though, and you are not the bartender, so fuck you. I'm gonna find my own fucking drink.
Thank you.
Does this smell like alien city? So you've had alien city. Other question. Will I get pregnant if I drink it?
Seriously, though, am I gonna get pregnant? Y'all can pull out your stupid cell phones now. couple announcements. When the pandemic thing, we went ahead and shot not one, but two more pay-per-views. They'll be out on Halloween weekend. ChristopherTV.com. ChristopherTV.com, that's where you go to get them. The first one is Parole Violator, me, obviously. Featuring Conditions Amount Parole, plus, plus, and plus. The other one is Vias Reversal, a bunch of reworks from the Vias for Vagina era music. How have I been there? Guess I'm a black comment. Anyway. Vagina is the word of the week. The word of the week. Woo! So say it, partner. Vagina.
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 Vagina. But your old crusty motherfuckers think they know what's up. We're about to find the fuck out. So, vagina. Thank you very much, baby.
Oh, Chicken, I'm the most pleased that I raised. It's go time. Do or die. continue.